So Fire Force with this week's episode really starts setting up the future to this series, especially with the whole idea. I mean, we kind of get a taste of this crazy cult-like organization that supposedly has kidnapped Shinra's brother, and the idea of basically making Earth into a ball of flames and just there's some crazy shit going on. And that seemingly was the direction that we are going to pursue, and I'm sure the other divisions were also going to pursue it. And we get a taste of the other divisions, the leaders, things like that, but ultimately where this episode ended up was that Shinra's crew, the 8th Division, all agree that, if he believes his brother is still alive, that's what they should pursue. Not just going after this organization to take it down, but to uncover the mystery of his family. And I think that was a really nice way to end this episode, but also set up the future, because this episode, it really does slow things down. Compared to the last couple of episodes, it was brutal, it was intense, there was a lot of action, a lot of stakes on the line. This episode, there's paperwork, there's making dinner, there's a lot of simple bonding slice of life design scenes, but that's not a bad thing, especially after everything that just transpired. I think we need an episode like this, cool things down, but also help progress and set up the future of the series. I quite like just like some of the smaller details. Like we see that Arthur, he went somewhere, and then they just kind of like, they recognize Arthur went somewhere, but we don't know where he actually went. And I kind of like that. It's a little bit of a mystery whether we touch upon it again in the future or not. I guess remains to be seen, but it'd be totally in character for him to just disappear, go on a mission, and come back, and no one even bats an eye at him. He got all this stuff with Princess and the idea of her basically giving him lunches and just the whole thing going on with this crew right now. It is causing Captain Obi to have a headache, to say the least. His logger's being destroyed. There's just hijinks running amok around this entire crew. It's just funny, simple scenes. It's basically like every type of comedy that's been present throughout the past 9 episodes is in episode 10. It really does feel like we're kind of like slice of life into everything that we've kind of seen up to this point minus action. I thought it was pretty charming overall just watching all these scenes play out. But when it starts getting into the more serious of like, we have to start uncovering some clues, see what's going on. But then Joker comes in. Joker is a wild card. Like, really, you don't know what's happening with this character, whether he's full-on bad, full-on good, maybe a bit more anti-hero, we don't know, but every time he pops up, he's smoking that cigarette, he's looking a little mysterious with his eye patch going on, and he seems to know quite a bit, but it almost feels like he's trying to guide Shinra to what he wants, but at the same time, he wants to manipulate him for his own well-being, whatever his plan is, and that's what's super interesting about this, and I'm glad that, like, everyone around Shinra, they kind of called it out, like, can we really trust this Joker guy? And Shinra doesn't trust him, but he wants to believe that his brother is alive, and that's ultimately why they're saying, well, let's figure this out, let's pursue this, let's figure out what's truly going on here, and if your family really did burn that fire. I do like the idea that, like, when you have a character like Shinra, who's really determined to be basically like a superhero, he wants to make sure that he can protect people, and his entire goal is kind of driven by his family, and I think anyone in his circumstance, even if you get a mysterious character popping up saying your brother's alive, naturally you're gonna want to say, common sense is saying to stay the hell away from this, get this guy arrested. But at the same time, you would want to believe that your family's still out there. Especially with everything that you've seen up to this point with transforming humans into basically these soldiers and otherwise they combust and just go insane. It's not insane to believe that your brother could have been one of the chosen and been brainwashed to follow this cult. We've already seen a taste of what it does to people's minds. I mean, we saw some crazy shit going on, and it was very religious, and it was just completely batshit insane. So it's not ridiculous that Shinra would want to sort of hold some truth to those words, even if he doesn't fully trust the guy himself. And I think at this point, Joker might be probably the most intriguing character because we know so little about him. There's plenty of aspects within the show we don't know a lot about, but I feel like because he keeps popping up and he feels so villainous, but then he also kind of seems like he's helping our boy, but at the same time, we've seen dialogue that doesn't seem that righteous. Almost feels like he wants him a part of his crew with whatever he's doing. Maybe he's more anti-hero, maybe he's full-on villain, only time will tell, but I do like how every time he incorporates himself, he feels like a snake. The way he moves and just poses himself, there is just so many creepy shots with him, but he also kind of feels like, I guess we could probably have a cup of coffee with this guy, see what he has to say, with the voice in the back of our mind saying, run the hell away or punch this man before he stabs you. I just dig the fact that there's some pretty complex characters that they're not revealing their hands too early. They're letting us have some mysterious characters, characters within our own organization, characters that could potentially be a villain or even an ally depending on the episode. It feels like they're doing the right thing with kind of setting up the future of this anime, and as we enter the second core with next season, it's going to be incredibly fun to see who's going to be an ally and who's really going to be a foe. We're seeing apparently the top soldier in this organization, and he doesn't want anything to do with this, He just kind of does his own thing. Gonna be really wild, I think. I feel like as like we really learn more about the characters, the captains and things like that, there's gonna be some tension, and I'm not gonna be surprised if it kind of goes two ways. One kind of on the path of basically trying to ruin the way of life, and the path of trying to kind of expose this cult. And to see ultimately where like characters will end up and who will join Shinra's side is going to be fun, because right now, like, he's got a decent amount of support. I mean, if he was to try to take this head on, it'd be a pretty hard challenge. I mean, he'd probably end up dead, he'd probably end up brainwashed. We know and learn in this episode that his flame's like the pure flame, kind of mirroring what created the earth in the beginning, or so the tales say. So, like, it's clear why people would be lashed onto him, and you can understand why characters like Joker would want his power, because it's a very rare thing. Whatever he wants that power for remains to be seen. Maybe he's part of this organization and is just trying to lure him into basically their trap him in a spider's web, something to that nature. There's a lot of ways they can go with Shinra's kind of like holy flames, but it's gonna be fun. I feel like what this episode did, like, it's so basic when you really break it down. Characters doing paperwork, they're making their food, they're learning about Joker and things like that, but it really did feel like it was setting up the future. Setting up next week, setting up the second core, and I think these types of episodes are important. They can easily be dry and boring, but I think Fire Force has such a pleasant cast of characters that it's really hard for an episode to be dry or boring. Yes, it can be, like, a lot more simple and maybe not as intense as past episodes, like last week and the week before, sure, but when you have characters like Arthur, Shinra, Maki, like, all the characters together, Princess, like, you can't really have a boring episode. At this point in time, unless they're just by themselves looking out a window, yeah, that would probably be boring even if you had a character like Arthur. But when you really see them interact together, even when they're doing paperwork, even when they're eating dinner, it feels like, yeah, this is still entertaining at the very least. And as long as Fire Force can be entertaining while it sets up its narrative and future plot points, that's not really an issue for me. Unless we got like 10 episodes in a row like this, and yeah, maybe it's time to get some more action in there, maybe spice up the formula a little bit, but this episode, and just, you know, with last week and how they're structuring it, it kind of feels like they know what they're doing. Definitely still remaining with that fan service, but at the same time, they're remaining with pretty much everything that Fire Force has been known for. The ridiculous comedy, the ridiculous just reactions, which sometimes these reactions are just too much to handle, and I really do love it, I have to say, but I mean, probably the funniest part in this entire episode had to be our boy, Arthur. The man's just not cut out for anything that requires a long-term amount of thinking, and just to see how exhausted he is, but how he'll perk up if he hears about food. It's typical shonen comedy, but I love it, I have to say. But then again, I have a bias for this character overall. I just think he's absolutely hilarious, and I love his addition, because he kind of seems useless, but at the same time, he can be goddamn amazing when it counts in action. That is, I guess, unless he puts the sword in the wrong hand, and then he's kind of a useless asshole, but that's why we love Arthur. I feel like Fire Force with this week's episode, it just had a calming atmosphere to it. There was a couple of intense moments, sure. We got the Joker stuff, we got the meeting with the captains, but ultimately it was a calm episode. No action, no one was basically dying in this episode. It was, let's see where this series really wants to go. And ultimately, I thought it was a fun episode. It wasn't anything groundbreaking. I don't think this will be anyone's favorite episode of Fire Force. The past couple of episodes definitely are going to be stealing the show for a little bit here, but it still does feel like it knows what it's doing. It does have a plan, it has an objective, the trajectory, it seems like it has an overall good arc that it's going for. And as long as it can continue to stick the landing week by week, doesn't have to blow us away with animation, doesn't have to blow us away with action, just keep the characters exciting, fun, or fresh, and you're gonna have the fan base of Fire Force feeling rather happy and content more often than not. I will be honest though, when we started getting more characters like Princess and just the others starting to join or at least hang out within the organization for the 8th Division more and more, I was a tad worried that maybe it would kind of start feeling like too many cooks in the kitchen. There'd be too many personalities, not enough time for them, or it just kind of mesh into a... Honestly, it'd feel like just jamming a lot of people in a small room and just feeling like we're claustrophobic, but based on this episode and them just kind of sitting around and just like the mess that is happening because they're all just kind of ruining the captain's life right now, it does feel like the more characters we have, it won't be an issue. I think it'd add on to the flavor to the show, and depending on how the action evolves throughout this series, seeing how they'll work in harmony, I think will be pretty cool. We haven't seen like them work as a group as of late, but just imagining how they'll work together in the future, I think it's going to be pretty interesting. I'm sure we're going to have more of those basic kind of like, okay, there's an inferno, let's take them out, let them rest in peace. I'm sure we're going to have those again in the future. And I'm excited to see if these newer additions to the cast are going to aid in those like simple scenes, because I think their powers and just personalities will mesh quite well, but definitely feel like the additions to the cast are a pro, not a con in any way, shape, or form. And the more characters who join in with the 8th Division, I'm pretty excited for. And even just, you know, potential allies that will aid every so often for missions, I definitely think the cast have a lot of interesting formulas to mix and match with in the future. I thought this was a fun episode, music on point, voice acting on point, just overall, episode pretty on point for what it was trying to do. Nothing extraordinary, but it set up the future in an entertaining way, and that's all I asked for. What did everyone think of this week's episode of Fire Force? Did you love it? Did you hate your favorite moment? Manga readers, anime originals, whatever you're feeling, let me know down in that comment section below. If you did enjoy this video, be sure to drop a like, and also hit that subscribe button if you happy new. So until next time, everyone, please take care and have a good one.